Currently, our teaching staff is working very hard to determine what parts of their education that they're going to offer is going to take place on campus, face-to-face, so physically, and what parts are going to be offered online, because it is important to find a proper mix between online and on-campus teaching activities to have students meet the learning objectives. Every course and every study program has well-defined learning objectives. Well, basically, good quality education is straightforward. It's that mix of teaching and learning activities that enable students to achieve their learning objectives. And currently, as I explained earlier, teachers are working hard to find the nice mix, what should take place on campus and what can be offered online. And on campus, you can think of lab work, lab practicals, but also question and answer sessions, feedback sessions, and for instance, the kickoff meetings for group work. Well, but there's more to it. It's not only finding this mix. If you think about good education, I think three characteristics are important. The first one is a functional one, that is basically the content of the study program, of the domain. That is the title that appears on your certificate, on your diploma, animal sciences, plant sciences, social sciences. Secondly, it is important to realize that learning and teaching is very much a social activity. As students, you learn a lot together, with each other, from each other, by giving feedback, by having debates, by receiving feedback, etc., etc. So that is the second one. And the third one is subjectivity. As a student, as a learner, you need to position yourself in science, in the academic world. So what conceptual theories, even the opposing ones, are you going to choose and are you going to favor? And it's important to determine your own stand in ethical and moral issues. That is the third one. Well, the assessment is another important criteria for good quality education, because you want to check whether the learning objectives are being met, and that's what you do with assessments. Now, part of our assessments can also be offered online. We recently acquired a new software package for not only closed questions but also open questions. And there are, of course, many other possibilities. Group work products, presentations can be assessed online, essays, writing, assignments, etc., etc. There's another reason and another advantage that we offer most of the courses in blended ways, but also online, is that when students fall ill, for instance, cannot come to the campus, or haven't had the opportunity to travel to WURking and only will arrive at a later time, so they still can follow to a large extent our education. All this we offer basically to make sure that we avoid as much as possible any study delays. To support our teachers in offering their education in a different form, we have a whole range of different support, varying from very generic, so an offer in trainings or in webinars, presenting showcases, up to a set of help desks where you can call on for support, varying from Brightspace, the digital assessment tools, recordings of your lectures, etc., etc., to specific tailor-made support if you, for instance, want to redesign your course from learning objectives to assessment method. Finally, we have a lot of information available online. One good example, I think, is the WhatsApp What's New in Brightspace. That is an environment for lecturers on Brightspace where you can find, per teaching activity, a way to offer it online instead of what you used to do on campus. Well, the past couple of months, we acquired a lot of new tools. One example, and I think some of you as teachers, you worked with it already, is the virtual classroom, which is a new feature in Brightspace, our learning management system. In the course of August, also for students, MS Teams will become available, which I think is an added value. It's a tool that you you know, not only can meet online, but you can also work together on documents. You can share documents, etc. So I think that's an added value. And on top of that, we have a few smaller tools. One example is Train Tool to use for feedback on skills. A very nice example is the Peak app, which and especially for field excursions, where students can self-paced basically go out and do the assignments in their own time. And finally, Lab Buddy to assist and prepare students for lab practicals.